designed to be too strong because you don't want it to rip something off if it breaks, you know what I mean?
Right.
You want it to break before it hurts an airplane.
Must be pretty light, took off pretty easy.
So we just fly formation with this guy, like an Air Force. You know, he doesn't control us, we have to fly behind him. He only pulls us forward. So when you're learning to fly one of these, this is the hardest part, staying behind him. People want to go, they go all over when they first start. Yeah, all are up and down. Travis, he lives over there.
Well, they can change, I don't know. I mean, you think it'd be better to go that way?
Let's get a better look. We might see it. Let's see how it looks.
Quite a big valley up here.
Yeah. A lot of agriculture. They grow a lot of, the fruit trees you see are usually apricots or cherries. Then they grow a lot of lettuce and spinach and cauliflower and all that stuff.
Right.
The real purple fields are that purple lettuce.
And then
one over there, see the real purple, that's that lettuce.
Right. Where's San Juan Batista? Is that over there?
Yeah, you see that little town there? Right up by the hills?
Right there?
That's it.
Down to the end of the Monterey Peninsula.
That one that juts out right down there.
Okay.
Hudsonville is right off our right wing, and we're out there further. And at the top of that bay, around the bay up there, is the Santa Cruz.
San Diego area and a lot of off-roading there, but
yeah, go ahead and pull that thing.
Okay, yep. Ready?
When you fly a glider, the airspeed is by where the nose is, up or down. They call it the pitch. So if we put it down, it goes faster like this. See the airspeed pick up?
Right.
And if we pull it up, then it goes slower. But that's when you fly it, you want to keep it about right here. That'll keep it about 65 miles an hour. This white area up there, ground up there on the left.
Right.
Limestone. It's a mine. That area all around, this whole road that goes on this little valley is called the Wine Trail. And there's about six or seven wineries along there. That little valley, this side of that white is all grapes, and there's a winery there.
We used to ride the, in San Diego, there was, I lived right at the base of the mountains, and there was all kinds of trails like that. They're actually the access roads for the power lines.
Oh, I see.
So we used to ride those.
Oh, yeah. I don't know how they set it up. I know they have a dirt track there, too, and I don't know how they separate motorcycles and those quad things, or if they do or not. I don't know.
Right.
It's all like a park.
So is that the winery right there, or down the street in front of us?
Those all of those longer buildings?
Yeah.
No, that's some kind of agriculture. The winery is right just beyond that, though. There's Calera Winery here, and this DeRose Winery, which nobody remembers. I think DeRose Winery is right, those buildings there. And these are his vineyards here.
Oh, okay.
He lives across the street from me.
He lives right across the street from you?
Yeah, over here. We live right, see that green area? It's a golf course with a bunch of
right
houses. Yeah, out there where all the houses are.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Ridgemark. That's where we live. Now, they dropped the parachuters right out here, so we can't go over there. But they come up and they drop them right down in that field, just over there where those trees are. Yeah. Supposedly, right down here, the oldest operating, continuously operating winery in California.
Really?
Yeah, they operated during the Prohibition times because they made wine for the monks or the mission people there. The San Juan Bautista mission.
That's a nice view.
Yeah, so you see some of the bay, but that point out there is called way out there. That's where the town.
I know even over in the valley, it's rare that it's really clear. How often? I mean, sometimes you come out here and it's just crystal clear out here.
Yeah, but sometimes it's a lot worse. In the summer, you don't see the bay at all.
Really? Because of the fog coming in?
Yeah, the fog comes in. But it is hazy today. I don't know what caused it. Sometimes you can see the Sierra all the way over there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, one time I took my kids. I went to college and lived in Seal Beach. And I t- took my kids back out there one day, and it was went down Seal Beach Pier. We turned around, and from the pier you could see Catalina. Around and could see the backside of the Los Angeles Basin.
San Gabriel Mountains there?
Yeah, I mean, I'd lived there for 16 years and never seen it.
Wow. So, see how the pitch is with the airplane? Kind of get a feel for the horizon and the top of that.
Right.
If I pull it up here, you see the difference?
Sure.
And you put it down here, you see it, that's too low. So right about here where we had it, keeps us about 65. And then, can you feel the wings are level? Just looking out here, you better look at them first.
Right.
And you can see this part. If I tip it a little bit, you see that?
Right.
You feel that? Well, yeah, and then it goes this way. So I'm going to give it to you. Just fly it straight ahead. You got it. And keep the nose about where it was. See if you can.
Okay, so I go down, go up.
You can't hear anything, so.
Okay, I'm flying the plane, Joe.
You got it all. When you make a turn, kind of push on the rudder that you're turning to. Like if you make a left turn, go ahead and make a right turn and give it a little bit of rudder. Turn it all the way around.
What do you mean give it a little bit of rudder?
Yeah, a little bit of pedal. And then turn it all the way around so you're facing this way again. You can make it a little steeper if you want by pushing it over. There you go. Or nice and shallow like that. Know your nose is in the right position if you're about 65.
Right. Okay.
So you're pretty good. You're 62. That's good enough. Keep it turning a little sharper on the way. A little steeper bank. Push this over a little bit more this way.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought you were going to just. Okay, so we actually.
Got it still.
I got you. Okay. So then we're going to straighten out.
All the way around to 180. Turn it back the other way now.
Other way? And I'll give it rudder too?
Yeah. All the way around. A little rudder. You know you have the right amount of rudder when that string is just like it is. If you push too much, it'll go off. Well, that was perfect. Airspeed's right. Coordinated turn. Okay, let me have it for a minute. I got
okay.
It. Sometimes,
cool.
You know, it takes airspeed for the airplane to fly, right? To make the lift. You have to be going a certain speed to make the lift, or the airplane won't fly. Pilots practice getting too slow to see what it feels like.
Right.
Some people like to see it do a stall, and some people don't. A stall is when you get too slow, it shakes and falls a little bit. I'll do it if you want me to, or I won't.
Sure.
Do.
Yep.
Okay. Pull it up.
Okay, so airspeed's going to go down.
It's going to fall, and then I'm going to let it go down and pick it back up, so it'll be fine. There it goes.
Whoa!
And then I'm going to let it go down.
To pick up some speed.
Back up here. And then let it go down again. See those houses right down there.
Very
that's
cool.
Called a wing over. Do one more this other way. It doesn't really stall this way, but you get a feeling of weightlessness.
Right.
And that's a wing over. That's about all we do in this older plane. We do aerobatics if you want to in the other one.
And the single seaters, you mean?
No, they're two seaters, but not three seaters. And we have parachutes when we do that. Downtown Hollister in there. It's where they have the big motorcycle rally over here.
Yeah, I work in newspapers. I used to work up here at the Hollister. I was a systems manager for the company that owned the Hollister.
The what?
The systems manager for the company that owned the Hollister Freelance.
Oh, the Hollister
paper.
Freelance, yeah.
So I used to work up here.
Oh, I see. get in lift, you feel the bumps when you go up, you look at your little speed, you make a turn like this. So try to stay in one spot like this, you know, and stay right in it. Some people don't like that because it's hard on your stomach.
So you're saying, did you feel some lift right here?
No, I'm just showing you. No, oh, I just don't feel so,
but,
that,
no. But when you, if you feel, if you get into a thermal, you do that.
Yeah, you do a thermal. That's what you do.
Gotcha. Snow up here?
No. I've only lived here about 3 years. We've never had this.
Oh, yeah. We were like, Morgan Hill got it one year.
Higher than these hills. You know, they do in the Santa Cruz Mountains occasionally. Nice big house there.
Yeah, those are huge. Where'd you live prior to here?
Seattle.
Oh, okay. Got a brother up there. One's in Portland and one's up in Seattle.
Okay. No, we're still residents, so we have a place to live. Well, we had to move back when our kids had grandkids.
Good grandparents.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, mine are six. I got twin boys that are 16 and my daughter's 13.
Oh, wow.
But they had a very, very long day yesterday, and so none of them wanted to come up here and watch us fly.
What did they do yesterday?
They were all in marching band, and there was a... My daughter did Taekwondo for 3 hours in the morning, and my boys had to get up at 4:30 and get them to... They went and did a competition in Cupertino.
Oh, cool.
And then they got home at about 6:30, and then my one son is in jazz band that was playing at the theater downtown, so we went down to that.
Wow.
And they all had homework, and they just wanted the day to decompress.
Yeah.
So where's the airport from here?
Right over there, see it?
Oh, okay, yeah.
The art of this is not to get too far away too low. So
yeah,
we don't want to land in one of these fields.
Has that happened before?
I've never had it, but people do it. Usually they don't do it in this ship. They do it in club ships, so they're trying to go somewhere. Like they'll try to fly to Paso Robles or something. They don't make it.
Oh, gotcha, okay.
Call it landing out. Sometimes you can land out at an airport, but sometimes it's possible you don't make it. Then you damage the glider.
So that's kind of like the competition on gliders to see how far you can go.
Yes, they have these badges that they give you how high you can go, how long you can stay up, and how far you can go. So you get a diamond badge if you go over 1,000 kilometers. I don't know what it is, maybe it's 500. There's no tower here, so we, this is unbeknownst to where we are to other airplanes. So we can keep an eye out for each other.
I don't see anybody.
No, I don't either. Sometimes they're hard to see. I don't hear anybody calling in on the radio. That's good.
Steer with just the
rudders, that's all.
That's it.
When you get low, when you get low in speed, they don't work. It's only if you got air.
Very cool. All right. Well, thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Let me get out.
Oh, okay.